Hello and welcome to another episode of Transport TV. In this episode we are going to explain shortly about shortcuts. So what are shortcuts? We have here the documentation for the shortcuts that are used in Transport. Those are small tags that you can add in your WordPress post that have some indication to the Transport parser regarding the language used and regarding what to display, what to translate, and what generate. What we will do in this video, we will actually take the documentation here and we will explain what happens in each and every sample. So, let's create a new post. No shortcuts. Paste the documentation part. And leaving just examples inside. Could have prepared it in advance, but I wanted to show you how it's done on the fly. Let's go over the examples that are here. Here we have a short code that actually says that the following phrase is a Spanish one. It's hola. Hola means hello. So we already marked it in Spanish. So soon we will see what happens. Now we have a phrase that is marked as a Spanish phrase and have the added parameter of only. This actually means it will only be shown to users that have selected Spanish as their language. Here we have another phrase. This phrase is in Hebrew, but it will not be displayed to users that have either Spanish or French. Or we can simply have an English phrase that will not be displayed to French and Spanish. We also have here an example how to do it properly. Let's say we have a good translation of a complete phrase. We can, complete segment probably. We can mark the original segment thought to be displayed in a certain language. And the translation can be marked as in the language and only for the language. So hello. In Spanish, and we don't need to translate it at all anymore. And we have the ability to select the no translate tag. No translate tag means the phrase will not be translated at all. This is good for company names, for things that are global in nature. So let's hit publish and see what happens. We are going to the homepage. Okay. Let's go to the post. We see here, hello, not in Spanish, in French, Hebrew, not in French and Spanish, hello, and not translated at all. We are in English, but we can add a translation. This hello originally is hola. This one is originally in Hebrew. This is English, as we can see, and it has the break. This is originally in Spanish. Marked Spanish. Okay, we check that. Let's continue. And this is not translated at all, and we can't really edit this at all. Now, let's go to the Spanish. What we can see, a couple of new stuff, we can see that we now see Hola Español. This segment was marked just for Spanish users. We also don't see the segment in Hebrew and in English that were marked not to be displayed for Spanish users. And we also see that the Hola, which is the translation of Hello, now is being displayed and it's not editable because originally it's in Spanish. So there's no need to edit it. so we can do really neat stuff with the old shortcut. Most of this stuff was previously also available in the classes, the no translate class, and the support for other stuff, like the lang tag, which we were able to use. And we hope you will enjoy this version that now includes the shortcut, and have fun with CrossPosh 0.7.